Jesus came and he was born in a unique way. And in saying this word, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man. Jesus came and he was born in a unique way. And in saying this word, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Christ is the way of salvation, and in him we can have everlasting life. In Christ we can be forgiven. In Christ we can be reconciled. I tell you, my friend, you don't know anything about Jesus, about the Son of God, about the Savior of all the universe.
Son of God and the daughter.
I tell you, my friend, I have never heard, Allah raised the dead. Allah has never healed anybody. He has never opened the eyes of the blind. But Jesus did. Jesus opened the eyes of the blind. He raised the dead. And he cast out devils. And he preached the message of the kingdom of God. Now tell me, who is more powerful? Is it Allah or Jesus?
Allah.
I tell you, sir, Allah is not powerful. You know why? He has never done anything. He's not done even a single miracle. And yet you believe in something that you have no idea
of.
But when you read the gospel from the book of Matthew to the book of Revelation, you will find out that Jesus did many miracles. Do you want your teeth to grow?
You crazy man.
Then you got to believe in Jesus.
You know,
Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life.
He was the way of God.
No one cometh unto the Father but by me. Jesus is more powerful than Allah. Allah is powerless. He has never done miracles. He didn't raise the dead. Allah never created the world. But I tell you, sir, the God of a Muslim is a moon god. They worship moon. When you go to the mosque, you look on top of the building. What do you see? You see a star and a moon. That's what the Muslim worship. And I tell you, sir, when they pray, where do they face Mecca?
Like Jesus.
Where? You don't pray like Jesus. Why do you face Mecca? Tell me. But I tell you, sir, when we pray, we lift up our hand to God and we pray to God.
I tell you, sir,
the Muslim, they repeat prayer from Monday to Friday, Monday to Friday, repeating the same thing.
The Muslim always come to this track.
And they,
yes, they never allow people to speak in their garden.
That's
a little bit rude.
You understand English?
Yeah, they are taught.
You understand English? Everybody must understand Quran. Everybody.
Sir, what is a Quran? What is a Quran?
this Quran?
You lie. Tell me.
The word is Quran.
I tell you, sir, you can speak it, man. A few years, and yet you can speak it. You know what? You know your problem? You are all the time in Edgeware Road, smoking pipe, instead of going to English school to learn English. All right, you shut up your mouth.
You know, don't say a heart.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Jesus, Jesus is the Son of God. But you,
Jesus is the Lamb of God.
Jesus is the Lamb of God. You are going to hell, Monsieur. Jesus says. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Christ is the way to the kingdom of God. Do you pray 5 times a day? Do you pray 5 times a day? Do you read your Quran?
Yes.
Do you fast?
Yes.
If you do nothing, you go ahead. What is your problem?
In here.
Why do you speak in Arabic? And there's a lot of English people here.
Yes,
and a lot of English speaking people here. They don't understand your language, and you are here insisting on your language.
Go to hell.
Why can't you tell?
Go to hell.
I'm advising you, my friend.
Go to hell.
You better start going to
school. You're rubbish.
Jesus is the light of the world.
Liar, Ali Baba.
I challenge every Muslim here today that your God is a moon god.
Allah.
I tell you what, you go in a mosque. Who go in a mosque and look on top of the building, you see a star and a moon.
Come with me.
And if I ask you, do you know what is in the Kaaba?
Listen here, don't. Come with
you
me.
You like eating cheese kebab
on
a long beach?
Yes.
That's why you are insane, sir.
Yes, Yahmar. Yes.
Jesus came on earth.
No, Jesus, yeah, don't.
Not to condemn sinners.
La ilaha
but he came on earth. Allah will take you all to heaven.
Jesus is the light of the world.
You liars.
Savior, when you believe in him, you will have everlasting life.
Go to hell.
Why don't you go to hell?
Go to hell.
Will you ever go to Egypt? Will you ever go to Egypt? If you go to Egypt, all your remaining teeth will be taken away.
Yes.
The government are looking for you.
Yes.
You were the criminal in Egypt.
Yes.
Why don't you go back and face your sentence?
Tomorrow.
Christ is the light of the world.
You liar.
I challenge you on this.
Liar.
If you believe in Jesus,
liar,
you shall have
liar
everlasting life. This is a promise that
Baba
money cannot buy.
Baba.
You can work for salvation. Is a free gift that God has given to humanity. My friend, don't leave this world. Don't die before accepting Jesus. It will be a tragedy. It will be a nightmare for a man to die without Christ. Remember, Jesus, he will be the judge. He will judge all humanity. God the Father has given all authority to the Son. That's why Jesus says, when you look at me, Jesus, you don't only look at me, but you see the Father. Jesus said, I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. I and the Father are one. You can never separate Jesus from the Father. But you can be separated from Egypt. My friend, you can speak your broken Arabic. You can speak the way you want it. Every language you speak broken. When you speak English, you speak broken English. When you speak Arabic, you speak broken Arabic. When will you ever learn? I told you to leave Jesus above. Leave Jesus. Leave Jesus. What is in guilt? There's no such thing
that
in guilt. You understand Quran in your heart?
Yes.
What does Surah 4? Tell me, sir.
Yes.
Surah Maryam 4, I am 35. What does it say? You know, this man says he knows it in his heart. I ask him, you are sure that I know? He said, I
don't.
Why do you lie to me? Why are you lying to me? You said you know it in your heart. My friend, you have too much cheese kebab in your belly. You have to lose weight. That's what you need to do. Lose weight, my friend. Ladies and gentlemen, Christ is the Savior. Christ is our salvation. And trusting in him, believing in him, you shall have a free gift of eternity. That is why we speak to you today. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Christ, thank you, my brother.
Amen.
Christ is the light of the world. He is our salvation. He is our deliverer. He is our hope. Our hope should not be in a man or in religion or philosophy. Our hope must be in Christ Jesus, the Lord, the rock of our salvation. That is why, my friend, we can tell public that Christ is the light of the world, that Jesus is the Savior of all humanity. When you believe in him and you trust in him, you can have a free gift of eternity. Remember, my friend, it will be too late for many people today who are disbelieving who Jesus really is. You are opening a door to hell wide. When when you disbelieve in Christ, you allow the devil to come and hold you and drive you in hell. But Jesus came to open the door of heaven to those who will believe in him. That is why Jesus publicly, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Jesus proved himself that he was the Christ, the Son of the living God, the Savior of all humanity. I tell you, my friend, he was born in a unique way. He didn't have a father, but he had a mother. And not only that, Jesus, at the age of 33, did more miracles than any prophet that ever lived on earth. And that proved to us that Christ is the Savior. He is our hope, our deliverer, our salvation, our eternity. Trusting in him will pave way for you and I to be with God one day in heaven. But rejecting Jesus, you are opening the gates of hell wide. There are millions and millions of people who have been dead and buried, and they didn't believe in Jesus. Now they are burning in hell. Jesus, they said he's not the Son of God. I want to tell you something. Jesus asked his 12 disciples. He asked them a question. He said, who do men think that I am? Will you say
that? Hang on, my friend.
Who do men say that I am?
Hang on, my friend.
You know, his own disciples. They walked with him, they ate with him, they saw the miracle that Jesus ever did. But yet Jesus asked them a very simple question.
Liar.
Who do you think that I am?
Liar.
You know the answer was, you are the prophet.
Liar.
That is exactly what the Muslim
said.
You are some good man.
Liar.
You are a good teacher. But Jesus insisted.
Liar.
He said, who do you think that I am? I tell you, among the 12 disciples, there is only one man who gave the right answer. And that man was called Peter. You know what Peter said? Peter said, you are the Christ, the Son of the Holy God. And you know, Jesus said, flesh and blood has not revealed this to you. But my Father, who is in heaven, has given you this revelation. That's why the Quran is a book of lies.
You liar.
A book of lies.
You liar.
The Quran lies.
You liar.
The Muslims are liars.
You liar.
All of them are liars.
You rubbish.
Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one cometh unto the Father but by me. I challenge every Muslim that they believe in a pagan god.
Yes.
They believe in a moon god. Go to the mosque. What do you see in the mosque? A picture of a moon. Go to all their flocks. You see the moon.
To hell, I don't
care. I tell you, sir, the true God is a God of Abraham, the God of Jacob, the God of Israel, the God who created the heaven and the earth. How dare do the Muslims deny that Jesus is not the Son of God? Jesus said, I am the Son of God. You know what? The Jews pick up stone. They wanted to kill him because he said, I am the Son of God. I tell you, my friend, Jesus proved himself that he was the Son of God. You know what he did? He did miracles. He raised the dead. He cast out devils. He cleansed the lepers. He walked on water.
Jesus!
Allah, Islamic God, has never done a miracle. But the God of Abraham, the God of Jacob, has always been doing miracles. In Egypt, He delivered his people from Egypt. He did a miracle on the Red Sea. He used his prophet Moses, and the Red Sea was open. He provided food in a desert when there was no food. But where that? What did Allah do? Nothing. Never did anything. Check the Quran. You find no miracle that Allah has ever done. Why has Allah not saved you? You are insane. You're a liar, yes. And you're a hypocrite, yes. And you will never change. But I tell you, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, Jesus, is the Savior. Is our salvation. Is our rock. Is our deliverer. When you trust in Him, no more cigarette in age we're old. No more. No more halal meat for you when you accept Jesus. He is the way to eternal life. He proved himself. The scripture proved who Jesus really is. Even the devil know him. When there was a man who is possessed by a demon spirit and he lived in a tomb, no one, you and I can never go to the graveyard where that man is. When you go, you are a dead meat. But Jesus went majestically, the creator of the heaven and earth. You know, when a man possessed with a demon saw Jesus, he said, Jesus, you son of the Most High God, what have we got? What do you have to do with us? Do you want to torment us before our time? Jesus rebuked them, said, be quiet, and come out of a man. You imagine a man who had a demon for more than 50 years. Jesus came and he delivered him. He became saved. That's the power of Jesus. But the Quran, no power. You're just words. You don't have power. What power have you got? We're going to take you to Nigeria where people change into lion and snake. You're not going to come back. The snake will bite you with your Quran and swear on you. But when you have Jesus, no demon and witchcraft or voodoo can come near you. Because there's power in the name of Jesus. But the Quran is powerless book. Try that in Africa. Try that in China where there's Buddhism, witchcraft, and you come back and tell me you will leave the Quran and take the Bible and embrace the Son of God, the Savior of all humanity, who is powerful indeed in revelation, in understanding. His name is Jesus.